Okay, so if you guys hop on, last time you guys couldn't see me. I'm going to put some music on because it's going to drive me crazy. All right, let me know if you can see me. Heather, can you see me? Because my camera, yay, okay. Woo-hoo. Oh, jeez. I'm like, guys, give me like 15 minutes to go live. Good morning, good morning, good morning. Hop on, hop on. I'm excited. Too bad I can't dance. Morning. This is a daily mix that was made for me from Spotify. It's from the Tony Robbins, when I went to Tony Robbins. Good morning, Melanie. Are you working? Like we're in the clock. I don't even remember those days. All right, good. I'm glad that you guys see me. All right, I want to get right to this. Good morning, Paula. You girls are so awesome. I want to share some cool stuff with you guys that I learned. And you probably, some of you might know this stuff, but a lot of you will not, don't know. How much coffee have you had? That, Jordan, I'm going to share with you how I have this flipping energy. Well, yes, today. Today, how I have this energy. All right. I'm excited to chat with you guys today. I know it's true. Like, you could get, I'm not going to even say it because Facebook will put me in there if I play some music. Okay, so I'm excited to just chat with you guys this morning. I said that I was on the struggle bus, and I have been not all summer. And the struggle bus, I don't mean health and fitness, nutrition, all of that. I mean just like with being productive. So I want to share with you guys how to live a productive life. I'm going to blow your mind a little bit. And I'm also going to share another thing that I posted yesterday, and everyone was so like, oh my gosh, what did you do that was so different? First things first, let me share that. Good morning, Cheryl. Good morning, guys. Okay, so you guys all know me, most of you know me. You see me posting. I'm very hardcore in my fitness. I like to sweat. I don't really love cardio. No, I don't. But I really don't feel like I get a good workout in unless I'm like huffing and puffing and sweating, right? So I make a lot of judgments. As we all do, we always say, oh, you know what, I'm not going to do that because that's not my thing. Or I'm not going to try that because I'm not her. Or whatever, we make these things up in our mind. And I'm just going to tell you, like I did too, and I still do. So yoga, for me, was that thing. Like, tried it off. I tried it before. And I was like, dude, this is so not my thing. Like, I'm so bored. I can't, like, holding poses. Yes, it's hard. But my brain is like this. And that's one of the things I struggle with growing up and even in college. And I'm like this, like a squirrel. You guys, especially those that are on my team, know that I'm a squirrel. Like, I'll be talking about one thing and then I'll go here. And then imagine when I was teaching, like, that's why it was so entertaining, maybe, because I was a squirrel. So, you know, I'm like, what was I talking about? Imagine being married to me, my poor husband. So, you know, I'm all over the place, right? So I'm like, yoga for me, like to settle my brain and all of that. It's in my mind. I'm like, dude, that would be nice if I had the time to do yoga and do another workout that day. But who has time for two workouts? No one, right? We're very busy. I'm busy with the kids. And summer break is not a break. Like, they shouldn't call it break because it's not. Yes, I'm enjoying this time with my kids. I love being with them, but it's the end of August and they don't, like, this is the longest that, I mean, you guys, if you follow me on Snap or whatever, they're up my rear end. Like, I don't know why I'm so fantastic that they want to hang out with me, but yes, I'm going to enjoy it now because I know when they're teenagers, they might not like that. I might embarrass them, and that's okay because I want to. No, I'm just kidding. I don't. Okay, so yoga. I did it last night. I went to, it's called the Yoga Shop. It was unbelievable. Unbelievable. Like, holy crap. First of all, I'm strong, but some of that stuff, like these people are hand, if I did a handstand there, not with a wall or a headstand, that's what they're called, I would have taken people out. So I didn't attempt, I've attempted like the crow thing. I don't even know what they're called. But anyway, it was so warm in the room. I just felt the release of just everything. I didn't have my phone on me. There was no, I wasn't thinking about the kids or my husband or whatever, even though he texted me and asked me where I was because it took a long time. So it was just fantastic. And I recommend you doing things that are a little bit different. Something that a friend maybe asked you to do, or something you've been thinking about doing, but you don't think you're capable, or you don't think you'll like it. Like, that is not for my personality. No, that is not. But it's something that I really probably need. And after last night, like, I was crying at one point, just feeling a release of like, just all the stress of life that we all have, just like letting it go. It was freaking awesome. So that's what I want to share. No, I didn't get a Brazilian wax, although I never did, but I'd probably be open to that, even though it would hurt. I didn't get Botox because that would freak me out. And I would be afraid that I would have half of my face like, no, no. I did get my eyebrows done. We talked about that. And they're looking really natural, right? So I just have to get them like a follow-up type of thing. But I'm very happy with that. So, and it wasn't anything spectacular. I tried yoga for probably the fourth time, but in a better environment, a great teacher, and it was freaking awesome, and I need it in my life. So, with that being said, I want to just jump into this. So important. If you feel like you're the type of person, you never find time for yourself, you never do anything that you want to do because your brain, you feel like you have the world on your shoulders, you have the weight of the world on your shoulders. I want to help you guys, and I'm going to start talking about this more and how to live a productive life and make the most of your time. And first and foremost, what I want to say, like, I'm like on a high right now. What I want to say is, do not disregard this. Do not say, oh, it's not for me, or do not say, Just try it. And don't just try it for a day. Freaking try it for a month and see how your life has changed. Okay? That's what I just want to say, guys. Enough with us saying, oh, I can't be like, I can't run a marathon because I hate to run. I freaking hate to run. I hate to run. I'm doing this little try thing because, you know what? Who knows? It could be really fun. We'll see. Doing things outside of your comfort zone only helps you become the person you're meant to be. Okay, it really does. So I want to share, you guys have all heard my secret to my success is waking up early. Don't tell me you're not a morning person. I'm not either. And I'll tell you something. The past, I would say good month, I haven't been waking up early. Haven't. And guess what? I'm more moody. I'm a major B for sure. That's my husband. I don't get crap done. I'm in summer mode, right? Because the kids are home. I feel like I'm yelling more. I'm not as productive in my business for sure because I'm not waking up early. So that struggle bus happens to all of us. We all fall into that, right? But the important thing is to identify it and to get out of it, okay? So I want to share something that I learned that is so important. And it's going, and I hope that you guys really think about what I'm saying and you're like, holy crap, right? So I'm going to snap out of this immediately. And today was one of those days. I was like, dude, I'm getting up. I'm going to do what I normally do. I'm going to do my morning routine. I'm going to share a little bit of that. But I'm also doing a group about empowering ourselves to be productive and to live the life we're meant to. So if you want to hop into that free group, I'm going to put the link below after we're done with this. Okay? Anyway, and I'm just going to teach you these things in the group. And I'm going to also do a lot of fun other things that I'm really passionate about that can help. That can only help, right? Okay, so you guys know that I'm reading the 5-second rule, and I recommend that book for every single person in the world. Every single person, even my children. Like, I'm incorporating the 5-second rule into their lives as well because I think it's so important. So I incorporated that rule when a friend of mine asked me to go to yoga. She asked me, and I started thinking about how I felt about yoga. I let my feelings just fester a little bit, and then I said, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, I'm gonna go. I'm going. I'm not gonna procrastinate. I'm just gonna go. Let's set a date. Boom. Done. Because if I thought about how I felt about yoga, if I thought about how I hated it and what I didn't want to do and blah, 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 I would have never gone. And then I wouldn't have had that experience last night and I wouldn't feel as great this morning. Like, I woke up, guys, feeling freaking awesome. Okay, I'm going to stop there. So I think with our kids too, even cleaning my daughter cleaning her room, I'm like, Lena, just 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 it. Because you have to. You don't even think about how you feel about it because no one likes to do it. Just get it done. And I think it could help in every aspect of their life. Okay. So in the book that I'm reading, she talks about never hitting the snooze button. She says it sucks. She goes, listen, that was my life. Snooze, snooze, snooze. Guys, that was my life. I was never a morning person. My dad was, and I thought he was flipping out of his mind, like off his rocker. And he never hit the snooze button. And, you know, Mel Robbins in the book talks about not hitting the snooze button because there is a reason why, and I'm going to share it with you guys. It's not just because you get an extra couple minutes of sleep and then you wake up tired. Well, that's part of it. But it really affects the 4 hours in the morning after you wake up. Like, that's crazy, right? It totally affects the way, the productivity in your morning. So, and there is a reason why, and it might be more important than how many hours you get during the night of sleep. So scientists discovered that the snooze button has a negative impact on your first 4 hours of your awake time, okay? So you know how we sleep in cycles, and like if you guys have the Fitbit watch or anything like that, you know that your body sleeps in cycles. And I remember reading this when I was trying to sleep train my kids during nap times. Like, I found that every so often they would wake up. I think it was 22 minutes or something. So when at night, our body is in a sleep cycle of 90 minutes to 110 minutes. And then we go into those cycles. So some people wake up every 90 minutes or every 110 minutes during that, like there's a time frame. Naturally, a lot of us don't, but some people do suffer with insomnia and stuff like that. So what happens when your alarm goes off? Your alarm goes off, you're woken up, right? And what actually happens during those morning hours before that alarm wakes you up is that your body is getting ready to wake up, okay? So your body is getting ready, your alarm goes off, now you press that snooze button. What do you think happens when you press that snooze button? You fall back to sleep. Have you ever fallen back to sleep? Totally fallen back to sleep and actually turned off your snooze? And like woken up like an hour and a half, 2 hours later, like what the frick happened? And you're in a frantic maniac mess. Dude, I've done that before. 100%. Like, what happened? Oh my God. And then you're like, what time is it? And then you're frantic, right? There goes your morning. There goes your morning. But that's the reason why you're going back into a sleep cycle. So when your alarm goes off, and you press it is the worst feeling ever. You feel like you're like late with your job and like, oh my gosh, I can't stand it. It's scary, it really is. And sometimes I set two alarms because of that. That's how I used to be. I would set two alarms because I was afraid I was gonna turn the first one off and blah, or not hear it, that whole thing. So if you hear your alarm, a lot of times, what do? Cause we're not used, if you're used to hitting snooze, a lot of times this is what we do. The alarm goes off, we're like so groggy, exhausted, you know, and we start thinking, oh my gosh, what do I have to do today? Oh my gosh, what's on my email list? Oh my gosh, what do I have to do at work? When I was teaching, like, oh my gosh, like everything, the kids, my class, what am I doing? What am I teaching? Do I have to go to the store before I go? It was like, that was it. I got stressed out and I would press the snooze button. Right? And press the snooze button. And then what happens is you go back into a sleep. So if it goes off again and you actually do get up, what do you think your body or actually your mind is doing? It's in a freaking sleep cycle. Your body might be up, but your mind isn't. Your mind is like, oh, I'm back in the sleep cycle. You know, because you only have those 10 minutes, right? So your mind isn't functioning like it should be if you got up when the alarm first went off. Okay? So if you struggle with the snooze button, you keep pressing it, guess what? The 4 hours, 2 to 4 hours from the moment you wake up after you've finished pressing the snooze button, your brain is functioning in that sleep mode. That's why it's called sleep inertia, and you guys can Google it if you want to. But those people that are constantly tired, Lisa, it is called the 5 second rule. It's light, it's freaking awesome. And I recommend listening to it on Audible because she's funny and it's entertaining. Although if you do really like to open a book, both are great, but the Audible is great too. And some books on Audible I can't listen to because it's so annoying. Mamas that are getting up 2 to 3 times, it's same thing, guys. I'm telling you, you can, if you're getting 3 to 4 hours of sleep at night, you can still wake up and have a productive morning. Honestly, you can. I did it when my son Cade was waking up. When I started this business, I incorporated the morning routine because I had to. I was teaching, so I had to be functional at a teaching job, and I had a kid waking up at night. So it's possible to do, but it's a habit. Just like hitting snooze is a habit. Habits are not who you are. You're not, for those of you that say you're not a morning person, you can be. You can be. It's training your body. Just like you're training your body for a marathon, you can run a marathon, anyone can. Training your body to, you know, lose weight, whatever it is. It's a habit. You're breaking a habit. Break the habit of the snooze button. When that alarm goes off, you get up. You just get up. It sucks. And it's going to suck for the first like 5 minutes of your wake up. And it's going to suck for the first week or so. But it will get better. And then you won't need an alarm. And then you'll do your most productive work in the morning. And here's the kicker, guys. The big kicker. Most of us, there was a study done and it said that 1/3 of adults age 35 and under, so you know it's the generation of like the technology generation that we have going on here, check their phones during the night. Like wake up during, like after a sleep cycle, and not every one of them, but check their freaking phones. Like they can't sleep, check their phones. Why do you think we can't sleep? Because we probably live in a world like we do. We live in a world where we're constantly like this, right? So I want to challenge you guys, if you're going to do this and decide, and after you read, well, she shares her morning routine. My morning routine, I will share in my group. It's super simple, and it's not like you have to get up 10 hours before you have to. It's not like, oh, I'm waking up at 3 a.m. and this is me. No, 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 no. You start small. You start with a half an hour or 15 minutes before the kids wake up, getting some alone time, getting into a routine. Then you could bring it to a half an hour. And I find the people I work with, the longer, the more they do it, the more they want to expand that. So they're like, oh my gosh, the first hour of my day, like without a phone and nothing, is amazing. So that's the thing I want to share now. If you wake up, and you've only had like 4 hours of sleep or whatever it is, and you really need to wake yourself up, Tony Robbins uses an immersion bath. Like obviously we all aren't Tony Robbins. Get into a freaking cold shower for a couple seconds and you'll be up, promise. I know it sounds horrific, but honestly, your brain will be awake and your body will be awake. Like you are gonna be boop, awake and ready. All right. So a key thing for you to do this is my struggle bus thing. Like this is what I did all summer. I slept with the phone right next to my bed. Phones shouldn't be allowed in our bedrooms. I'm just going to say that. I'm just going to say that. So put it somewhere else. Put it downstairs. Put it in your bathroom. Put it, if you have to have it in your room, put it on the far side of your room. When that alarm goes off, you have to step out of bed. Once you step out of bed, you ain't going back in. Don't do it to yourself. Don't do it. Because you'll never look back at your life saying, I wish I freaking, you know, slept more. No, you're going to say, I wish I got my butt out of bed and like freaking started pushing towards my goals or doing something fantastic. So if you want to live a productive life, I'm telling you guys, it's in your morning routine. Successful people wake up early. And stop trying to tell yourself that you can handle it all without doing this. Because I did that for a long time. And I'm telling you, it changed everything for me. It changed everything. And it can change everything for you, getting into the habit, put your phone somewhere else. When that alarm wakes off, once your feet hit the floor, you continue walking. It will get easier every single day. If you want to be held accountable, if you want to join my free group and get into this with me, great. Do it. Let's do this together. And I can tell you, I see a huge difference. I told you in the past month when I wasn't doing this, of how I react to the kids, how I react to my husband, how I don't have time for, I don't have time for what matters. And that is for me, it's God, and that's horrible. It's my quiet time, just being in silence. Imagine what silence can do for your mind. It's reading something that is gonna affect my day or my life, something of personal growth. And then starting my day. Like, it's not opening up emails first thing I wake up. It's not checking my Facebook. It's none of that garbage. Because do you really want to fill your mind with someone else's crap? What the first thing you do when you wake up? That's what you do. That's what you do when you check social media right away. Yes. It, Melanie, isn't it true? 4 a.m. That's what I used to do when I was working as a teacher. People would be like, you're freaking crazy. I thought my dad was crazy for doing it too. But once you start doing it, like, your person, everything, attitude changes. Don't you want to live a better life, right? We don't want to just be going through the freaking motions. We want to find time for what matters. And what matters is being present. What matters is being productive during our work time. Like, this business that I run and that so many people have done and have done this with me, the ones that are successful are the ones that are productive during those special work time. It's when you're like all over the place and scattered and stressed and you can't do this and you're trying to fit it in during the times with your kids, and that's when it sucks. That's when, like, you know, your life is in shambles. Don't you want a productive life, right? Don't you want to live something that you're really enjoying and not just kind of surviving? Well, I'm going to teach you how to the best of my ability, because guys, we all fail. I failed this past month big time. I failed my whole flipping life, but it's called fail forward. That's, if I didn't fail and screw up so much early on in my lifetime, I wouldn't be here, right? So I mean, it made me who I am, right? All right, I'm just going to read through a couple of these and then I'll hop off. Yes, I love that, Katie. It's so true. You're so much more productive. It's when you go back to sleep after you've been up. It's also, that happens too sometimes, guys, when we take a nap. Like, I'll tell you something I know for myself, and this is not, I haven't researched this, but when I do take a nap, getting up out of that, I'm like a freaking hot mess for a couple hours after. It's almost not worth it for me. All right, let me just. I'm just going to read to see if anyone, life-changing. And you know the reason why I say it's life-changing? Not because I saw it in my life only. I work with women that I've seen a shift in their life. A shift in, like, what, or their wellness, their attitude, their productivity. When I have women waking up earlier than I do, sharing their morning routine and checking in, I'm like, these women are rock stars. People that have said they are a non-morning person, people that have said that I'm crazy, they could never do this. Like, that's the thing. So if I can do this, not being a morning person, being very lazy in my prior life, and if I can go to yoga and freaking love it and do something different, you can too. Why not? What do you have to lose? A couple hours of sleep? Seriously, it'll be better for you. All right. So that is it, Chica. Okay, Lisa, I've always thought that if I get up early to work out, I need to wake up a bit and check email or Facebook or whatever to wake up. Yes, Lisa, no, you don't. Don't do that. You can listen to a great book like The 5-Second Rule and then get into your workout, and you will feel a hell of a lot better than if you were checking email and doing all that crap. You could do that at work. I'm so crabby if I go back to bed too. Oh my gosh, I'm so glad that I'm not the only person. And guys, it's not going to be freaking cool the first day. It's not going to be cool the second day. You may feel more productive. You're going to be freaking tired because your body's not used to it. Just like anything in life, when you first do a workout, your body's freaking tired. You just got to suck it up. Like, we just got to stop being pansies. I said it. I'm sorry. It's true. Like, just suck it up. Let's put our big girl panties on, and let's freaking do this. We are strong. A lot of you guys that are watching me right now, you're strong women, strong moms. If we could freaking have babies, dude, we can get up early and rock our lives. That's all I'm saying here. All right. I will talk to you guys later. I'm going to put the link in here if you guys want to join. Let's do this. We're going to kick it off the day after Labor Day because I know school and all of this is chaos, but it's going to rock your life, and especially at this great time going into the school year. So I'm excited. I'll talk to you guys later. Thanks for hopping on too.